songs is so different for everybody. And for me, actually, it's been different in different seasons of life. You know, I've had seasons where I can spend a lot of time pouring into one line. And then I've had seasons where you got to get a song done in 45 minutes, you know, and I don't love doing that, you know, but you can, you know, and this time it's involved, you know, I was really purposed right from the beginning that if we were going to do something, I just wanted songs filled with the name of Jesus and to keep declaring the finished work of Christ over people's lives, not just how we feel about what God's doing in our lives, but just declaring what the Word of God says. And so you'll see all these songs talk about revealing Jesus, declaring Jesus, just the Word of God put to music. And that's been very much on purpose because, I don't know, I just feel like it's a little bit of a take authority album. Stand up, understand that Jesus says it is finished. You know, we have an authority, and that's kind of where all these songs have bubbled out of. You know, we've lost too many people, myself personally and many others, to cancer. And it was one of those things, you know, that just lurk around in my heart. When I'm singing these songs, I'm kind of standing up against sickness and disease and against poverty and against those things that would come and just rip people off, you know. So yeah, it's all in there, and it comes out in the writing. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So you'll hear it right throughout this project.
Oh,
rehearsal, we were just practicing this song. And again, in my spirit, I just sensed that if you are suffering cancer, if you've been given a death sentence by the doctor, whatever it is, we're going to sing this thing over you. We're going to sing these words straight from the Word of God. God is fighting for us. I hate cancer. I hate cancer in Jesus' name. And so we stand up, amen, and in the name of Jesus, not in our own strength, but in the name of Jesus, sickness has to flee, it has to bow down to the name of Jesus. We declare the finished work of Christ in his place. We declare
matchless love, beauty, endless worth. Nothing in this world will satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me.
Nothing in this world can satisfy. you remember kind of where you were or what you felt when Darlene said, hey, I want you to be a part of this live record that I'm doing?
She sent an email, and I thought, I just stopped. I was like, this is awesome. Yes. And, you know, I didn't even have to pray about it.
Right.
You know,
it's certain things you don't have to pray about.
No, sure. You just know. Yes, yes, please. I will be there. You tell me when.
Brilliant.
And I'll make it happen. So.
Brilliant. So then you guys got, did you do it by Skype as far as how you started the Victor's Crown, or were you in?
I was actually in Australia, in Sydney, and we got together and started writing. And girls writing is probably different than guys writing. We talked more than we wrote.
Sure.
But we had a voice memo going the entire time, and we'd work on the song and then get sidetracked and work on the song. So, and it was 6 voice memos just all cut into pieces that I had to listen through. And I just thought, we can never discount something that God starts. It didn't finish that day, but God definitely helped us start something that day.
Yeah, no.
You know, and you just can't discredit those kind of moments. And so I just told her where to listen, where the song points were, and then you guys.
Well, and she, I think it was either that day or the next day, she said, okay, Carrie has sent me this, we started on this, and I want to play it for you. And we were on Skype. So I'm watching the computer, I've got my guitar, I'm kind of waiting for this moment, and she turns the computer like to the side, so I can't even see her. I just hear, and she starts with, you are always fighting for us, heaven's angels all around, my delight is on the knowledge that you wear the victor's crown. And I was like, stop, like, just stop. Like, she went through, she played some other stuff, and I'm like, go back and sing those first 4 lines again. So she's saying, and I was like, this is a hymn. This is like a modern hymn where the victor's crown needs to show up in every verse. And she's like, oh, okay, well, that's cool, you know? And I just watched as we started getting into the song, and she's like, I want to say something like, you know, every high thing must come down, you know? I was like, okay, that sounds like the right way to start the bridge. And then she just starts, she went into like Darlene declaring mode.
Yes.
And I remember through Skype, bad speakers, the whole bit, just going, okay, there's something there, you know, something significant. So I remember texting you going, I think we got something here.
And you both texted me, and then I didn't answer back within like an hour or two. Y'all were both like, hello, do you love it? We love it.
Don't you understand?
This
is, we feel like God is here.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's really precious. And to hear it was one thing, but to hear it live with people singing it, I just, tears rolling down my face, just watch these women declaring with their hands in the air, every stronghold must be broken, you know? And I just thought, there's something so powerful in this song. It's amazing. I think sometimes we come to worship and we think we need to press in, and it's like this striving thing sometimes, but the Lord is on the move, and lifting his name and declaring who he is, the enemy has to flee.
Yeah.
That's what the word says. And so I think this song is going to help start to just shift something in the church where we are reminded that let's worship him and put our eyes on who he is, because he's the one that's already victorious.
That's right.
He wears that crown. He wears the victory. You know what I mean? And so it is not about us. Worship and all of that, it might make us feel closer to the Lord by the time we're done, but it is to bring glory and honor to who he is and to exalt him and magnify him. And in us doing that, I think it puts so many things in perspective for people's lives. We leave church going, God is in control and he's breaking strongholds in my life.
That's it.
He is victorious and I am victorious.
That's
because
it.
Of him. And it's fun to be a part of helping people say those things.
Thank you. that you wear the victor's crown. You're my help and my defender. You're my savior and my friend. By your grace I live and breathe to worship you. At the mention of your greatness, in your name I will bow down. In your presence fear is silent, for you wear the victor's crown. Let your glory fill this temple, let your power.
I mean, really, it really comes down to one thing, is I love this girl, and she's authentic, and it's never a chore when we have to work together. It's sort of like, why don't we do this more often, you know? It's just so easy, and I just think that's a testimony to, really, bottom line testimony of who she really is inside, and it's contagious, and I love it. When I was touring in Australia, it was awesome to be at the Grove and sort of tinker and see what happens, you know. And I'm still a huge fan of the hymns. And I've always been especially fond of My Jesus, I Love Thee, you know. So we just started worshiping. We just started sort of just getting lost in it because it's such a powerful hymn. And just never forget sort of, I kind of came up with this, I don't know if you call it a chorus or whatever, but it was a moment in that studio that, like, we couldn't talk, you know. It was just really beautiful. I'll really never forget that the rest of my life, you know. And it's on the record. And I didn't really go there to, oh, can I write a song for your live record? It just was all on the fly, you know. That's the cool thing about writing with Darla. You never know what's going to happen. And but boy, it was really a beautiful moment, and just rehearsing it, you know, obviously getting ready for this big night was, even just the rehearsal was pretty powerful. So very grateful for that hymn. Ultimately, we want to just declare freedom for the world, you know, and there's nothing better than seeing somebody get set free. And I think that's what this record and this DVD is going to do. I mean, you're just going to see breakthroughs, and people are going to, they're gonna get set free, you know? And I think about, you try to think about all the things that are going on in the world, because it can make your head spin. The evil that abounds, the evil gets more evil. Thank God the good's getting better, you know? But I've always said there's not a plan B. I don't think there is, and I think we're called to go out and rescue people at the end of the day, you know? And we just get to do it through music, which is the most powerful communication in the world, in my opinion, you know? And so it's a great opportunity, really is.
Jesus. God, we really need to lift Jesus higher. Let's shout his name. Come on, let's praise him.
but you're